I'm not gonna get the last piece in because the battery's going dead. Isn't that the way it always is? And always expect your battery to go dead on the last whatever you're doing. You have to recharge it. Good to have two batteries. I have two, but the other one is dead too, I think. Ah. Don't you hate that? Yeah, I'm gonna get this done anyway. Spike myself. Will it make it? This is the dead battery. One more screw to go. Here we go. Alright, we're all done with that. So, tomorrow we'll come back. We'll put the insulation on, the vapor barrier. It's vapor barrier and insulation. You saw that in previous videos. Nothing to it. I'm going to find my bit. So there you have it. That's basically it. Skinning it. You're putting the inside skin on, the framing, the curb around both edges. So, yeah, basically 2 days of work. Two short days with a lot of breaks. I figure I got, maybe 4 or a little bit more hours in it today, and probably about 6 hours in it yesterday. So, could have done it in one long day, but I don't work like that. So yeah, tomorrow we'll go ahead and get the insulation on there and try and get the front skin on. The front skin is waiting right there. It's a little bit beat up, but I have plans for that, so I'll fix it up the best I can. But the lower portion of it up to about here is going from, you know, from there all the way up after I put it on, is going to get some diamond plate like stuff as a rock guard. So it's going to cover up these dents anyway, but I am going to go ahead and push them out the best I can, but they'll be covered up with a nice shiny rock guard. So won't even have to worry about that. Okay, now when you go down and buy a set of plugs, you can get these at any auto parts store or RV place. This is called a 4-pin flat wire connector. Four wire flat connector. Sorry about that. The wire is even flat. And you get a male and a female end. This is the female end. This end goes on the truck. And the reason for that is it doesn't have any exposed metal parts, pins, except for the ground, which you don't care about. And this is color coded. You want this color code to be proper on all your trailers and all your hookups to your trucks, because that way you can just jump from one to the other without having to rewire everything every time you move something. So the way it works is your ground is the white wire. This is totally different than any other wiring you've ever heard. Your ground is the white wire. Okay? Normally ground would be green, but in trailer talk, green isn't ground. Okay? So just forget about everything you ever learned about electrical wiring when you start talking about trailer lights. Okay, and according, and I never can remember it, so I always keep one of these boxes around, because they usually have the color code inside for what each wire is supposed to be. Let's see if this one is still here. If not, I'll have to refer somewhere else. Yeah, here it is. Your tail lights, which are, in other words, your running lights, not your brakes and not your blinkers, your running lights or your tail lights are brown, the brown wire. So no matter what color it is here, we're going to want it to be brown when it comes out this end. Your white wire is ground, of course. And let's see, the right turn signal is green. Okay. So I guess the left turn signal would be yellow. Yeah, why it does, yeah, yellow would be left turn signal, green would be right turn signal, brown would be running lights. And inside your truck's brain, or inside the whole thing's brain, when you put on the brakes, all it does is make the right and left blinkers come on and stay on. And then if you have a blinker going at the same time, it continually disconnects that left light. So basically, your brake lights and your tail lights are the same wires. So that's why you don't see anything about brake lights on here. This is really just set up just so to make it easy for you. Yeah, right. So at any rate, I've got a bunch of wires coming out of the trailer, and I checked them all out and marked them before I covered everything up again. It was the first thing I did when I tore the trailer apart. Now my blue wires here, back in the old days they did things funny, they didn't have any standards to speak of, but anyway, the blue wires are all for internal lighting. One blue wire is nothing more than a ground, and I have it tied in a knot so that I know that that's a ground. That means frame ground, aluminum ground, okay? And because you don't have a ground wire going to all your tail lights and running lights and blinker lights and everything, that's why they have this. This doubles as the ground. Make sure that your ground is good all the way from one end to the other, because 99.9% of the times when you have an electrical problem with your running or tail lights, it's generally a ground problem. Most of the time it's a ground problem. Once in a while it's the actual light itself, but most of the time it's a ground problem. So whenever you're trying to troubleshoot, make sure your grounds are all good before you start troubleshooting, because that's usually the problem. The other two are positive and negative for the internal lights, and they're not marked, so I'll end up marking them by running a wire to each one and just using a tester to see which one's which, and I'll mark them with tape or something for positive and negative. We don't have to worry about those right now. I do have the ground marked though. Okay, what we're interested in right now are the running lights, and coming out of the trailer, they're black, red, and brown, whereas normally it would be brown, green, and yellow. Well, I marked which ones were which, the way they had them wired originally. So this black is my left turn signal. So I'm going to want to make sure that my black wire here is connected to, which one is left here now? Is it green? Right turn is green. Okay, so seeing as how black is left, I'm going to want to make sure that it's hooked to the yellow wire on this. Okay, so what I'm going to do is go ahead and run, because I don't have enough wire to make it to the front of the trailer yet, I'm going to go ahead and run some of this. And this is the proper color, so I'll make the connection inside the trailer, and I'll put it somewhere where it's easy to get to in case I ever need to. So I'll go ahead and make these up now, and then I'll show you the end result. Alright, so as you can see, I've notched through the framing and routed my wire. It's just going to hang down there until I put the metal on. It'll stick through. So I've got all the wiring done now. I'm going to go ahead and insulate it.